month ago, 2023, December, me and my family went to go buy some groceries to eat in Christmas and to have a good time. We want to go buy cool things for Christmas. Then we want to go buy some groceries. Then me and my brother went to the drink section. We saw the drinks. And I saw a drink say sugar free. So I'm getting all hyped up and saying, this is gonna be a good day, me drinking no sugar. After we're done paying for the things and going back home, I drank. Then it tasted like there was sugar inside. Then I tell myself, how can be sugar inside when it is sugar free? I started learning and trying to know why. Then I stumbled upon that not only sugar can control you or can spike your insulin, it can also mean that other chemicals that can manipulate your mind to think that is real sugar and it tastes like sugar. If you do not get me with this, if you ever tried this before, we have drank Coca-Cola for years or maybe decades. We're still doing it today, but some people, as they're going to self-improvement, trying to improve and improve and improve, the one thing that they misunderstand is sugar. Even if it's in a sugar-free can or bottle of drinks. For example, you're saying Coke is saying sugar-free. Then you taste it, it tastes like sugar. If it had no sugar, it didn't have a taste, right? But you saw that it said no sugar. Then you took a sip. You look at the ingredients, they say sugar, 0 grams. But when you look at the ingredients, there's some words that you don't even understand. You don't even know them by brain. Remember this time when we were young? We like to eat sugar these days, right? When we were young, when we saw our parents going to make some tea or making something that is sweet, we might go up to them and ask for a small full of sugar on our hands for us to eat a bit. Don't lie to yourself. You have done this a long time, and that experience is fine, brother. It's fine. But as you continue eating sugar every single day, drinking Coca-Cola, eating junk food every single day, there's one thing that sugar can do to your body. It's called insulin. What's insulin? In my own understanding is that insulin is the alarm that indicates whether you are full. If you eat a normal meal with no sugar, with no crappy things on your plate, you feel full and tired that you want to go take a powerful nap like a real king. But if we eat a lot of sugar, it kind of like blocks it from us being full. Then we keep eating, binge eating, eating, binge eating, then eat, and then we become fat as we were before. You were from here with no sugar. Now you are here coming back to the person where you were before. This then, when you keep eating sugar and sugar every single day, that insulin bar from its full potential, it will be down here. From up to down here, you are already binge eating every single day and every single time. When you binge eat, it's just like you scrolling on social media or fapping. You're kind of like bored. You don't have anything to do. Your work is done for the day, and everything you have done for the day is complete. Then there's that time period where you do something that's unproductive, like fapping, like scrolling on social media or binge eating. When we binge eat, it's like we're bored, and trying to tell ourselves in my mind is that I'm bored, I need stimulation. That's what you're telling yourself. If you are sitting on your bed and you're eating crisps after crisps after crisps, whilst you know that you wanna be the best year of your life in 2024, you're just sitting there eating some packets of crisps and crisps. That isn't gonna happen in the real world. When sugar is inside our lives, it kind of like damage our own mind and body. Sure, there will be times where you are going to a social event and you take that sip of coke. It's absolutely fine. But the real key that I want to go to is that you mustn't prioritize sugar every single day. No 20 grams, no 30 grams of sugar a day. If you know that it was 20 grams of sugar today, why don't just say, make it as progress, 17 grams of sugar. Then you continue wrapping up and wrapping and wrapping and wrapping and wrapping. Then there will be a time where you're gonna be on 0 grams of sugar, which I would call the carnivore diet. The carnivore diet will consist of anything of single ingredients, which I'll touch with that in later and future videos that I'm gonna be filming. Reduce your intake of sugar. Reduce the amount of binge eating and of wasting time on something that isn't productive. There will be times where you're sitting down and you just ate a packet of crisps, because it's not always perfect. It's not always perfect, but as you putting work consistently every single day and every time of the day, you're gonna be thriving like a real man in today's modern day. And there's one thing that can make you to stop, not forever, but make you to stop eating too much sugar, which is to improve mental health. By improving your mental health, it would be way easier for you to say, sugar, you're no longer in my body. Get off. Let me just go focus on my work. That's powerful, man. That's freaking powerful. You keep working and working and working and working. You keep progressively overloading and reducing the amount of sugar you eat. And today, I did a math. I wasn't supposed to tell you this, but today I did a math. The amount of focus I had in the mouth, I didn't even see the time. The time was flashing by. I didn't even notice the time was going fast and fast and fast. Then I realized that it's gonna be 6 p.m. Then I say, training your mind and mentally can get you a long way. By you improving your mental health every single day, of your life, you will maintain that kind of relationship and life forever. Improve mental health, then everything will start coming to you, and you'll notice that other people are chasing for validation and for women, whilst you are chasing for your goals and mission. That's it for me today. Hope you learned something that you can implement in today's world. By you improving every single day, you're becoming very close to the 1% of men who are trying to become and to improve their life. Guys are down there, like and subscribe to join our cult, and I'll see you in the next one. As I always say before I go, hard times great, strong men.